Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم says سبعة يظلهم الله في ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله. Just ruler who treats people with dignity and justice, who treats people with kindness, who does not oppress people. شاب نشأ في عبادة الله. A young man or a young woman who spends time not in disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the righteous way, doing righteous things, reading Quran, memorizing Quran, reading نهج البلاغة, reading الصحيفة السجادية, close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, waking up for the morning prayer, going to the masjid, pray jama'ah there. Allah loves this kind of person. رجل قلبه متعلق بالمسجد إذا خرج منه حتى يعود إليه. A man or a woman who loves being in the masjid. His heart is attached to the masjid. Frequently visiting the masjid. Trying to perform most of his or her prayers in the masjid. There are many ahadith in Islam emphasizing the point that the masjid should be always the center of activity, should not be kept empty. ورجلان كانا في طاعة الله فاجتمعا على ذلك وتفرقا. Allah loves two people whose relationship, friendship is not based on interests. What brings these two people together is the love of Allah, the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worshipping Allah. Their friendship is not personal based, rather it is based on serving other people, loving other people, caring for other people, and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obeying Him. ورجل ذكر الله عز وجل خاليا ففاضت عيناه. The other person that Allah loves is a person who is by himself and he remembers Allah and he fears Allah. He doesn't do this to show off. This comes naturally out of his heart. ورجل دعته امرأة ذات حسب وجمال فقال إني أخاف الله. Another person that Allah loves is someone who would not indulge in haram sexual activity. ورجل تصدق بصدقة فأخفاها حتى لا تعلم شماله ما يتصدق بيمينه. Other person that Allah loves is a person who gives sadaqah, but would not talk about it, would not brag about it, so much so that when your right hand gives sadaqah, don't let your left hand know about it. Do that for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when you give for the sake of Allah, Allah knows about it, Allah will multiply it for you.